G'day guys, I thought we'd do a video on importing a RGB sequence onto your layer. There's a couple of steps to this. It's pretty straightforward. There's been a few changes recently in xLights, in particular this change temporarily and change permanently show directory folders, which is a great function. So what we're going to try and aim to do as part of this video is import, like I said, one of RGB sequences, one of our Christmas sequences. In particular, we might use these Rascal Flatts, Life as a Highway, from the Disney Cars movie sequence. We've looked at it. We're not going to go trying to make this into a sales pitch video. But we've obtained our sequence, we've downloaded it, and we've ended up with our first steps. We've ended up with in our downloads folder a zip folder. So what I suggest to everybody to do is within your show folder. So this is on my computer D. We've got Christmas. This contains the RGB effects folder and our networks folder for your layout. So this is going to be an example of your layout. This is not our layout, this is your layout. We think it's a pretty generic type good layout, which we borrowed from somebody just to use for these demonstration purposes. So we've got an imported folder. Very important. This imported folder for our sequences is within our show folder. So here we've put our what we've obtained is our once we've downloaded our sequence, our Rascal Flatts, Life as a Highway. Now this is called HD all, so this is for that high density for those extra props. That layout hasn't got them, but we'll talk about that later. So my first recommendation, I copied that from my downloads into this thing. We're going to make a new folder, and we're just going to call it Rascal Flatts. Now this isn't always, or I could spell. This isn't always necessary, but once you get two or three sort of imported sequences, it just tries to keep up your file structure a little bit neater. So I've moved it just straight into there. Now what we need to do is to extract all those files. So we'll do that, and you'll notice once we've done that, we've incorporated a couple other files as part of our packaged sequence for you guys. We now include some sequence import tips. We include a mapping guide, which we think's nice and easy to follow and to use. Our sequences are performed at a group level, so it should make that import process sort of easy. But this is, included as part of your sequences. So we still haven't actually got to the sequence yet because this is in another file which was in that downloaded zip file. So the next step is then we have to extract this second file. So we'll just extract it there. Okay, hopefully this is going to extract nice and quickly there for us. And you will notice this starts with a number. So that's telling us it's one of our sequence files from us. So Life is a Highway, and you'll notice that this has got RGB sequences, networks, and RGB effects in there, and it's also got the sequence file in there. Okay, and we have some images. Right, yeah. So now what we want to do, so we've downloaded our sequence, we've put it into our imported folder, we've made this Rascal Flatts folder, we extracted all the information which gave us, the PDF files with import tips, and also then extracted again the actual sequence on RGB sequences layout. So now what we want to do is we want to import this to our own personal layout. Now some people will go into xLights and go file open, and they'll try to import open this directly onto their layout or do an import direct. There's one really important step, guys, which we need to make and do, and this has been facilitated really well really recently with the xLights team, so a big shout out to those guys with this change temporarily show directory folder, because what we need to do is first open the sequence that we've obtained on the sequence provider's layout and then save it, and then change our show directory back to our own personal one, and then import the effects. Because what that will do is it will make sure that any video files, any GIFs, any images, etc., or shaders, which are being used on that imported sequences, it'll tell your computer the file path and where to obtain them. So to open this sequence, this is the first step, open the sequence first on RGB sequences layout. So we want to change temporarily our show directory file. So we go to where we are imported. We had Rascal Flats. 21 Rascal Flats. So we're going to select that folder. Give it a second to, my computer's a bit slow. Notice here too, it's changed the color. That tells that we're working in a temporary sort of changed show folder. And we can just, you know, go back to our permanent one by selecting that one. So a quick way to find out, now we've got some null information there, but you know, quickly, you know, that's RGB sequences layout there. So then our next step is we want to open that sequences on RGB sequences layout. That's quite a simple task. File, open sequence. We've already obtained the music file, so we've already got that. Rascal Flatts, Life is a Highway. So we're going to open that. And xLights will open this up for us. This might be a little bit slow because I'm doing some screen recording at the same time. So now, you know, that's on RGB sequences layout. We could hit the render button there and play it through and have a look at it and go, yeah, I like those effects as well. I can think I can, you know, that's going to map across all right. But you will find our effects have all been applied on a group level except for our mega tree and a matrix. So one thing we want to look at is look at our layout and look what sort of groups RGB sequences is used. So there's a all house prop, there's, you know, one without the mega tree. Generally we don't use whole house effects. Most people will have a lot of these groups already set up, but some of the important ones are, which we use all the time, is our arches. It's pretty straightforward. Candy canes, our floodlights. We won't go into these high density props for this video. We'll talk about that a little bit separate. We've got our house outline, which is, you know, the eaves, so to speak. We've got our house verticals, you know, some vertical elements. You know, we've got the separate icicles. You know, the rest is pretty straight, pretty common. You know, mini trees, mini tree stars, etc., etc. So what we want to do then, we've just made a bit of a note. Remember, we also include that mapping guide as part of that package sequence. So you can print that out, have a quick look at it. But we think our groups are pretty generic. So then we have a very important step. We want to save this sequence on RGB sequences layout, which is within our imported show file. So I'm just going to hit the save icon there. It's saving away. Okay, it's saved. And then we can go File, Close Sequence. We'll close out of that. Now we're going to go back to our layout screen and our controller screen. Now we want to go back to our own personal layout. So we can go Restore to Permanent. So there. And that's taking it back to our own personal layout. So this is where the fun begins, so to speak. This is where we've already gone through. I said, we RGB sequence on the group level, except for, say, matrices and megatrees and stuff like that, megatree star. But, you know, we've already set up the groups. These groups have already been set up. Just one group in particular we want to look at is our house outline group. So this one here is called house group outline, and then they've got some vertical elements. They do have a house roof group, which some people like to use. We generally try to use all our outlines together as part of our sequences, but we did, now there's other options you can do. So then we go File, New Sequence. So we're going to do a musical sequence. Now we need to find the music for this Rascal Flatts one, which we've obtained. Okay, 20 frames per second, quick start. Okay, so we've got our sequencer, the music's sort of in there. Now we want to import the effects onto our props. And once again, xLights makes this super easy. So we just go import, import effects. There you go, well, where's the effects? Where are they? We need to go find them. So remember we had that imported folder? Imported. Rascal Flatts. Rascal Flatts. And then you'll notice here we've got our sequence. This is the one which we saved on RGB sequences layout. So we're going to import their effects. So then it opens up the, you know, the import mapping window. Again, it should be nice and straightforward. You will notice there's some other, because this is the high density layout, there's, we don't have in this, our personal, on that layout we use demonstrating on, you know, we don't have the Rosa wreath or the mother of all wreaths or the Boscoe PPT Geo wreaths, but we'll talk about them in another video. One great feature which has been introduced recently to xLights, so another big shout out to those developers, they're automatically importing all the timing tracks, because we do use beat count a fair bit and so do a lot of other sequences. So then we just simply grab our arches, we put that onto the arches group. They've got a they've got a candy cane group. We'll come back to that one in a little minute. We've got our floodlight, so we're just going to match up our pretty obvious ones to start. Just notice the groups and ones we're importing are nice and blue, so we can identify them easily. So you've got this house group outline, house group vertical, and the house roof group. So we're going to use the house outline to that house group they have. And then we've got some vertical elements, and we'll put them onto there. Then they've got their mega tree and a matrix, which we have. We have a matrix, so that's just matrix to matrix. And then we have a mega tree. And a mega tree star. Now they've got some mini trees. They had their set up with the stars as part of a group and without the group as well. So we just want to use the mini trees from RGB sequences onto the mini tree only group in this example. And then they've got their stars. That's pretty well most of the groups which they had set up. We did have the candy cane group. And we'll just go up to candy canes. Now on some of the non-high density RGB sequences, we don't include candy canes, but you will find spiral trees generally work pretty well for those smaller type vertical props. So just a tip for you. And they don't have any spinners on their layout or snowflakes. You know, there's the snowflakes, you know, you could simply map across as well. Okay, so next step is another sort of tip. You want to save this mapping. You might think you can, you know, it's pretty straightforward on this layer, but if you've got, you know, various other props, if you save this mapping, I would just put it probably in my imported folder, mapping. We'll just call it, you know, RGB sequences. So the next time go to import a sequence, we can just load that mapping file, and it'll bring up this previous mapping layer we had, so you don't have to drag across. This one's been fairly straightforward, but we know for some of the larger displays, it's a nice little time feature. This is where some of the people goes, oh, it's a one-click import, because they've already saved these mapping files, and it is, truly is. After you've saved it, you can load that input, load the mapping file, and away you go. So then we'll go, okay. So that's brought in all our effects really nicely into our layout. Remember, it's imported them onto our layout. So we're going to hit the render button and see where we go. Now I'm on my laptop here. Let's see what it's rendering reasonably quickly for us. It's a first render. So then all I like to do is actually to save this sequence. We're going to go file, save as. Within our show folder, we'll save it. Rascal flats. And we'll just hit the save. And we'll see. This is the fun bit. We'll see what it looks like. So we'll bring our house preview up. Expand that out so we can see what's going on. Obviously, I didn't have the house preview load. I think I've got hopefully audio on quiet so we don't blast your ears. We'll go to the start of the sequence and... So notice we've got our images that we used as part. So those files were correct. Our house outline's looking pretty good. Our hand stands are looking sweet. Our matrix is looking really good. Arches are doing their thing. That looks like a really successful mapping to me. So that's how we can map RGB sequences sequence onto your layout. Now I'm just going to do a quick overall review of those couple of quick tips. The first one, when we create an imported folder within your show folder. So we've got that imported folder, that's for our imported sequences. It can be from other people's sequences, it doesn't have to be from RGB, it can be something off the Google Drive or from another sequence. Vendor. I like to make a folder name to put the zipped folder I've obtained. Just remember, RGB sequences contains a zip folder within a zip folder, which can be a little bit confusing. That's just because we're also giving you those mapping guides and some sequence import tips. So you've unzipped it. You've got the RGB sequences layout and the sequence files available. Then we go to our xLights. We go to that change temporarily feature. We change it to RGB sequences folder. And then we can open the sequence up, import it across, save it, change. Go back to our personal show folder and then import the effects into render, save it, render and save, and away you go. All right, guys, thanks for watching.